Welcome to Five Element Friday! You get an element, and 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 you get an element!
Everybody gets an element!
It's all five elements! And it's Friday. Welcome back to Five Element Fridays. My name is Jay, and I'm here with Lita in the studio, and today we're going to talk about metal.
Yes, today we're continuing our conversation about goal setting and the five elements, and it's all about the metal magic carpet ride.
Woohoo! This just sounds like a good
thing,
right?
You don't know what we can find.
Well, you don't know.
On a magic carpet ride.
I'm not even touching that one. All right, just to bring you up to date, we're doing a short series on the five element goal setting, and today is going to be all about metal.
Yes, and we need all of our five elements to set and achieve our goals.
You know, there's an interesting thing about metal. It's a bit of a dichotomy. On one hand, they don't seem to have a lot of goals.
Yes, they're really more defocused in life, and especially compared to woods, who are really focused.
Yeah.
And at the same time, however, they have this incredible preciseness about them, and they love to be organized.
I think it's a little different than the wood organization, which is more about to-do lists and strategizing.
Yes, it's more about physical space. They like to organize physical spaces and design them.
Boy, we all need a little metal in terms of that in our achieving our goals, because that's where a level of accurate makes all the difference in the outcome of whatever you're doing.
Yes, and they see things in black and white, and some of us like some of the woods and fires,
what?
Present company not accepted, see shades of gray everywhere and fudge everything all the time.
I like fudge.
Yes.
I think sometimes fudging helps you achieve your goals from the wood perspective.
Until it doesn't, and then it bites you in the bleep.
Okay, so the only example I can think of is last time I tried to make fudge, and I didn't have a recipe, so I kind of fudged the fudge recipe.
Perfect.
Let's just say it did not come out perfect, almost perfect.
I can imagine.
I should have called one of my metal friends and asked for a recipe.
Yes, you had to call on your own metal to make that work.
Which is last.
So metal pursues truth and integrity with a personal, like, internal vengeance.
Yeah, no excuses. They hate excuses.
And we can all benefit from metal in us to hold ourselves accountable to our commitments.
Yeah, so if you're a procrastinator, get in touch with your own metal to kick your own bleep bleep into action.
Yes. However, you know, there is always a challenge for each element, and for metal, it can be the pursuit of perfection. If it can't be perfect, then why bother, is how they think.
Yeah, like, I could have gone and got the recipe for the fudge, the actual fudge, and made the best fudge ever, which I wanted to do, but things just got in the way and time, and so I had to fudge the fudge. And while it may not be the metal way, it worked for me.
Yes.
No one really knew, but I knew, so we're talking about the integrity, so yes.
But what if you're metal and you're so precise that you, like, take hours and hours and hours to make fudge?
I just kind of jumped into it without thinking about it, and that's what woods do, but whereas metal...
Yeah. It may even stop them from doing it if they can't find the right recipe
or
the right ingredients.
Measuring cup. Yeah. I'm like, no, I'll make it up as I go.
Yeah, they just don't roll with it the way wood does.
So it could stop them from, you know, making the fudge.
Stop them entirely. So it's also sometimes that, you know, they're making commitments to everyone else and not doing what they need for themselves.
And they might get resentful since they hate confrontation. You know, they might end up withdrawing, holding that anger inside until they become powder keg and they just go crazy on someone.
Yeah, and if they follow what they feel like is their duty to be responsible to everyone else, then their goals and dreams might slide right by them until they're living a woe is me life.
Eeyore.
Yes, Eeyore.
Because you made me think, go right to the Eeyore. They can get stuck and they don't do anything. They just walk around in...
feeling bad for themselves, I guess.
Yeah, 100-acre woods with nothing to do, but... just complain.
It's funny because as good as they are at keeping commitments, if they see no way out, then they just stop making any commitments and come up with tons of excuses why they're not, you know, and they hate excuses, but In this case, they use excuses for why things aren't working out.
Yeah, and they're just not much fun to be around when they're in this mode. So if you're stuck in metal and the world around you is your excuse for why you're not doing what you want, look at your wood to get you out of it.
Yes, activate your wood to make some changes.
Your metal needs to ultimately to be free to wander, and you're going to need that wood to give the impetus, the energy to move forward so you can get on that magic carpet ride.
I like to say that metals are happiest when they are the knight errant, like from King Arthur times. You know, someone who roams around and saves those damsels in distress.
Or the dams. Yeah. Damsels could save the dams. Yes. Right? Damn it. Okay, they love to be in service. Is that what you're saying? They love to be in service. Yeah. They don't want to be tied down anywhere too long. You know, they want to keep moving around. They want to wander, make connections. They love connections. Make connections along the magic carpet ride.
Yes, and it's like that song, also The Impossible Dream. It's the ultimate metal song. You know, as a little girl, it always made me cry. I had to ask my father not to sing it because it was just so full of metal melancholy.
Yeah, it is kind of like this, you know, sad but happy kind of inspiring song, but it's sad.
It's sad and inspiring at the same time.
I know you were playing it all week and I'm like, dude, stop. Dudette. No, stop.
It's like to dream the impossible dream.
To dream the impossible dream. To fight the unbeatable foe.
It is a very inspiring, but it's definitely a metal song.
Yes. And you know, as sad as that song makes me, I can see how this is such an essential ingredient for all of us. It's that willingness to keep going based on our truth.
Yeah. And as woods, I'm going to speak for all the woods, as glorious as they'd like to be, sometimes they walk away when the going gets tough. And we need a little bit of metal to help us keep going and make that fudge perfect, that recipe. So here we go. Let's wrap this up here.
Yes, so we can reach the unreachable star.
Let's go forth and reach for the unreachable. But if you're wood, you'll reach it.
Yes, there you go.
To reach the unreachable star.